Welcome or welcome back. In my previous video, we explored the concept of modes in schema therapy. While schema therapy is a highly specialized form of therapy that requires a skilled and knowledgeable therapist, there are some visualization techniques and exercises you can use on your own to care for your inner child. Visualization is a powerful tool that can help you access and work with different parts of yourself. These techniques can be helpful if you struggle with feelings of vulnerability, fear, and sense of being unlovable or unworthy. By practicing these techniques, you can develop greater self-awareness and self-compassion and learn to manage difficult emotions more effectively. So today we will be discussing how you can use visualization to strengthen your happy child mode, care for your vulnerable child, and manage your angry and impulsive child. But before we start, I want to remind you to subscribe to this channel and hit the like button below. By doing so, you'll be supporting my mission of promoting mental health awareness and providing resources to those who need it. So let's get started. One of the key concepts in schema therapy is the idea of modes, which are different parts of ourselves that can come to the forefront in different situations. One important mode is the happy child, which represents our playful, carefree, and joyful side. To strengthen your happy child mode, you can use visualization techniques to access and amplify those positive feelings. So, how do you do it? Start by finding a quiet, comfortable place where you won't be interrupted. Relax with your eyes closed. You can use meditation, hypnosis, or just a relaxation technique for this exercise, or just take a few deep breaths, allowing your body to relax. Now, visualize a scene from your childhood where you feel happy and carefree. Maybe you were playing with friends, exploring a new place, or enjoying a special treat. Picture yourself in that moment, feeling all the positive emotions that come with it. How did you feel then? What smells and sounds were there? Who else was present? What elements of that experience can you also incorporate in your current life? Hold that image in your mind. Imagine that you are taking those positive feelings and bringing them into your present self. Allow yourself to feel happy, carefree, and joyful in the present moment. You can do this visualization exercise anytime you need a boost of positive energy or to reconnect with your happy child mode. Another important mode is the vulnerable child. If you experience feelings of sadness, abandonment, or anxiety without clear reason, it may be an indication of the presence of a vulnerable child mode. If you want to understand your vulnerable child mode better, you can answer these questions. To care for your vulnerable child, you can use visualization techniques as well to create a safe and nurturing environment for that part of yourself. So again, find a quiet and comfortable place to sit. Close your eyes, relax, and go back in your mind to the child you used to be. How did you feel then? Try to accept and allow the feelings you had as a child. Now visualize a scene where you feel safe and supported. Maybe you are in a cozy room with soft blankets and pillows, or you're outside in nature surrounded by beauty and peace. Whatever scene feels most comforting and nurturing to you, imagine it in detail. As you hold that image in your mind, imagine that you are bringing your vulnerable child into the safe place. Allow yourself to feel comforted and supported as you care for that part of yourself. In your mind, you can put your arm around your little self. What did you need back then? Are there ways to make sure these needs are met now in your adult life? You can do this visualization exercise whenever you are feeling overwhelmed or need to show yourself some self-compassion. The vulnerable child mode makes you feel sad, weak, lonely, or inferior, and it can be really painful. The angry or impulsive child mode makes you feel strong and powerful, but you may feel ashamed afterwards or have a mix of anger and sadness. Impulsive child is more about getting what you want and feeling good in the moment. But it can cause problems in the long run, like debt or relationship issues. If others tell you that your behavior is inappropriate or you are being a pain, it might be a sign that you need to change. These statements can help you figure out if they describe you. However, keep in mind that questions can only provide a clue. Your own opinion is the most important. When we are in the grip of our angry or impulsive child, it can be challenging to control our emotions and behavior. Visualization techniques can help us manage our angry child by giving us a way to pause and respond more thoughtfully. Getting these modes within you under control happens in two steps. The first step is understanding which needs this mode is related to. For this, think of a situation where you become angry in a childish way. Examine your feelings. Do you feel unfairly treated? Is there also a wounded child mode active, causing you to feel sadness, loneliness, or rejection? What need did you feel at that moment? Did you want to be taken seriously, accepted, or were you looking for boundaries? The second step is finding a good way to satisfy those needs, instead of getting angry. For example, express your need. And now visualization exercise. Once again, find a quiet and comfortable place to sit, close your eyes and take a few deep breaths, allowing your body to relax. Visualize a scene where you feel calm and in control. Maybe you are meditating by a lake or you are sitting in a peaceful garden. Whatever scene feels most calming and grounding to you, imagine it in detail. As you hold that image in your mind, imagine that you are taking slow, deep breaths to calm your body and mind. Focus on the physical sensations of your breath, allowing yourself to feel more centered and in control. When you feel ready, imagine a situation where you would normally feel angry or reactive. Visualize yourself responding calmly and thoughtfully, rather than reacting impulsively. You can do this visualization exercise whenever you are feeling triggered or when you know you are going into a situation that may provoke your angry child mode. It can help you feel more prepared to respond in a way that aligns with your values and goals, rather than getting caught up in the heat of the moment. By strengthening your happy child mode, caring for your vulnerable child, and managing your angry or impulsive child, you can develop greater emotional resilience and self-awareness. Visualization techniques can help you make positive changes in your life and feel more kind to yourself. It's important to give yourself time as you practice and get help from people you trust if you need it, like friends, family, or therapist. And I hope this video has been helpful for you. Please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more videos like this and share your thoughts in the comments below. And if you want to stay connected with me outside of YouTube, be sure to follow me on my social media. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.